Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 14 Beta 1 has been out for almost a week at this point, and I've been using it primarily on my iPhone 11 Pro Max like normal, also my 12.9-inch iPad Pro from 2020, and the iPhone XR. So these devices have all been running pretty well, and a lot of you have been asking me, how can I get the beta on my phone? And currently, you need to be a developer in order to get the beta. There are other ways to get it, but if you're not sure what you're getting into, I would really suggest waiting for the public beta to come out. Then it's usually a little bit more stable and you're able to use it on that without a problem by going to apple.com/beta. And it's pretty simple to install that way. However, if you're in the beta and you want to go back to iOS 13.5.1 or iOS 13.6 when it comes out, you won't be able to do that unless you use a computer. So just keep in mind, this really isn't for everyone. It's for early beta testers, and it will come out to public beta testers probably in a few weeks, usually sometime in mid-July, and then also the final release will come out in the fall, usually around late September, maybe October this year. Now, there's a few new features I wanted to go over. We'll talk about when iOS 14 Beta 2 should come out and when iOS 13.6 should come out. But the first thing is a couple new features, and one of them is low power mode for an iPad. And I showed this a little bit in Shortcuts. It's there, but you can actually ask Siri to actually turn on low power mode. So I'll activate Siri, turn on low power mode. And it says low power mode is there, even though there's not a setting for it. So you can turn it back off, turn it on. It's on the iPad, so maybe they'll have some other battery health features in future betas, but right now they're not there. Now, also one thing that I didn't cover in my video about this was they've removed the wheel to input different things such as alarms. So instead of having a wheel where you scroll through, which I actually prefer, you now have a number pad. Some people like this better. Some people like the wheel. This could change closer to the time it releases. But right now, if you want to put in an alarm, you could do 8 o'clock in the morning and set it up that way. No more scroll wheel to get through that information. Now, a small change that people have recognized in iOS 14 Beta 1 that I didn't cover in the video about iOS 14 is that you can zoom in a little bit further on photos. So if you go into a photo, maybe we'll pick this one of the new icons, and then we'll zoom in to QuickTime. You can zoom in a little bit further than you could before, or maybe what the new Final Cut Pro icon will look like. This is what they showed, at least in the keynote. So you can zoom in a little bit further than you could before. So we have that ability now. It may be helpful if you have some larger pictures or some fine editing you want to do and things like that. Now, Apple has also updated the field test mode. This allows you to see the signals of what your phone is doing as far as transmits and receive. You just go into your phone dialer and you'll see this is what it looks like. They've changed the way it looks. So you can see here's my transmit power for my cell phone signal. And this just lets you see a little bit more information about that. This is more for if you're trying to see what the signal is actually doing. So they've updated the way that looks. Now, before I talk about some of the bad experiences I've had with iOS 14 Beta 1, let me talk about some of the good things. And the first thing is performance actually is quite good. Scrolling is nice and smooth most of the time. You'll see here's my app library, my list views, and everything is nice and smooth most of the time. I'm not sure why it picked that picture, but it's what these all are set to do what they want and change throughout the day. So my photos will change, these apps will change, and it's nice to have that option. Using the operating system in general has been really good, with the exception of the problems I'll mention in a moment. But speed has been good. I'll talk about battery in a moment. But first, let's talk about some issues I've been having. And some of those are touch not working properly. So sometimes I'll go to scroll. Sometimes it seems to be more in apps than in the operating system itself. But I'll go to scroll and my touch input won't work. I've had that a few different times. I've had Twitter be slow or freeze and not respond at all, especially the keyboard. So if I wanted to send a new tweet, I could say, this is a new tweet. And I won't send this, but you get the idea. It seems to be okay now, but sometimes it's super slow and buggy. So most of the time it's working fine, but sometimes it's really slow and it has occasional freezes. I've had a few apps crash, such as music. I've had music crash a few different times. Just listening to it, it'll crash if I add something next, stuff like that. And it's been okay. It's much better than other early betas, like I said. I've had a couple resprings when trying to set wallpaper, so I'll set a new wallpaper like the one here, and the whole thing will respring. And then I've had some widgets that won't refresh properly. So maybe the weather isn't refreshing properly, then it will, and that's fine. It's early on, like I said. And then finally, I have the storage bug that many of you have been seeing. So if I go to general, I go to my iPhone storage, you'll see it's using 247.5 gigabytes of 256 gigabytes. The system is using all of that storage. Now, I expect Apple to fix this with updates, so that doesn't concern me. If I needed the storage, I could reboot the phone and reinstall everything and just start over. But right now, the storage is taking up the system is taking up almost all of my storage. Now, with old devices, people are saying that the battery life is okay. Again, basically the same as all the other devices, but they are saying performance is good and things are a bit buggy from time to time. With iPadOS, I've actually had a pretty good experience, and in general, it's quite good. I haven't really had too many issues with iPadOS. Seems to be working fine. I have had a few issues moving icons around, but other than that, nothing serious. But I have had to reboot my iPhone a couple times when it wasn't working properly. I just did a hard reboot and it went back to normal. The same is true on the iPad. So you will have some bugs. Now, like I said, it's been pretty good for me overall though, and those are a few bugs that I've had. That's pretty typical of an early beta. In fact, iOS 13 beta 1 and 2 were so unusable that I actually went back to iOS 12. I haven't had to do that yet with this beta, so that's a really great sign. It's working great. Now, as far as battery life, this is really hit or miss depending on who you ask. Based off the YouTube community poll I'll talk about in just a moment, it's very hit or miss, but let me show you my battery life first, and then I'll talk about your battery life based on that poll. So if we go to battery life, you'll see my health is still at 97%. It's pretty typical. The update will not make it go down. However, iOS 14 may be measuring it differently or more accurately, as some people have seen this number fluctuate compared to what they had on iOS 13. Now, you'll see that over the last 10 days, my battery life has been not great. You'll see here 2 hours and 19 minutes of screen on time, 4 hours and 41 minutes of screen off time, and I'm using almost 50% of my battery. That means I'm getting 4 to 5 hours of screen on time and maybe 8 hours of screen off time. Before, I was getting 10 to 12. Now, this is not everyone's experience, as I've seen other people tweet about this, but some people have had really great battery life, other people have had horrible battery life. This isn't a big deal to me though, because I think this number is wrong, because even though right now you'll see it says I've used it 2 hours and 34 minutes and it's saying that I've used it almost 50%, but I've only used it 18%. So if you look at the actual battery percentage instead of the actual battery usage stats, I think you'll find that you have much better battery than you expect instead of looking at these stats. There's something off here. Again, it's an early beta. And if you're having a ton of issues, make sure you report it in the feedback app, because Apple will use that information. Now, based off the YouTube community poll, 24 of you said that your battery life was good and 43 of you said it was worse than before. So that means worse than iOS 13 0.6 or iOS 13.5.1. So just keep that in mind. It's an early beta. I expect this with that, but just keep in mind that it's not going to be great. And all of the issues mentioned you can see here on the left, as well as all of the different devices that you're using are listed here as well. So thanks to everyone that mentioned that in the poll. Let's go ahead and take a look at the YouTube community poll. Now, 9.3K people voted, or over 9,300 people, so I really appreciate it. You'll see 20% of you said that it's great, 2% say it's terrible, 11% say it's okay but has some bugs, so only 13% or so are having issues with it, and 52% of you are on iOS 13.6 beta 2 or older, and 15% are using Android. So this number has actually gone down this week based on what we've had in the past. Now, I took all of that information that you've commented about in the poll, put it together to give you what we had a little bit earlier as far as what issues you were having and that I'm having and about battery, but let's take a look at some of these comments. We'll go through about 10 of them or so. Now, the first one says, when will iPhone XR get iOS 14? It will get it the same day as everyone else around the world. When Apple releases it in the United States, it's released everywhere around the world at the exact same time. But keep in mind, this is a beta, so you won't see the final version until September or October, like I said earlier. It has been working great. The only problem is that Pokemon Go does not work, so I'm expecting an update soon. you shouldn't expect an update from Pokemon until the fall. They don't actually accept apps for updates with the latest OS until then. So they may update Pokemon, but don't count on that. You may need to downgrade your phone in order for that to work properly. It's stable, fluid on my iPhone 11 Pro Max. Battery is good as well. I'm on iPhone 6S. My widgets won't load up and my phone shuts off randomly and battery drains fast. Really amazed by the stability if you're using it with a normal use, surfing emails and calls. Some tweaks need to be done, but overall it's really good. Very, very polished and optimized for a first beta. The iOS 14 Beta 1 file is humongous and took up an additional 12 gigabytes of storage, which over time slowly reduced to 5 gigabytes in the other storage space. Battery drains rather quickly, especially compared to 13.5.5 and 6, but still lasts me a full day. Notice that the interface and all the animations are much more smooth, especially when notification drops down a very subtle and eye-pleasing animation. Widgets run perfectly except for the fact that it takes time to update and start up, especially after restarting the device. One of the most stable betas ever. iOS 14 is a great OS as well. However, battery drains faster compared to iOS 13.6, getting about 1.5 hours less screen on time. iPhone 7. I'm amazed at how great the first beta is. I look forward to it getting better over time. I'm running it on the 11 Pro Max and the iPad Pro 11. I'm on the iPhone 8 Plus. It's been running great. There is some bugs as expected, but it's probably been the most stable next generation of an iOS release I have ever tested. I'm running it on an iPhone 10R. The mail app seems to have gone backwards some. I noticed my icon shows unread messages, but opening the app and no unread messages. Previously under 13.6, I could select all the messages in mail and then run my finger down the left to select any number of consecutive messages to take action. And this is now gone. Battery life is not as good, and my cellular connectivity went from an average of -105 to more like -111. And I think you're talking about the actual field test mode as far as your signal strength. Now, as far as the mail app, I agree. I noticed that was gone and just forgot to mention it a little bit earlier, but I think they may add it later on, or at least I hope they do. I use that when you can select a bunch of mail messages at once. However, mail has been really stable for me. I've had no issues with it, so it's been great this time so far. Pro Max, it's been great for a first beta, a few bugs and app issues, but that is expected. There are a ton of bugs for me, but I am still enjoying the beta. It's been mostly nice. There is no back tap on the iPhone 8 though, and so far my Amazon Music app doesn't want to work. Great iPad Pro 2018 and Pro Max. Overall, I love it. So-so battery, occasional graphical lags on the iPad, such as icons returning to the dock after going home. Keyboard is laggy on both occasionally. Sometimes a struggle leaves scribble mode to get a keyboard to show. Nothing bothersome at all for a first beta. On my iPhone 6S, everything is fast. I don't know what really fast is on a smartphone. I'm on iOS 14. It's great, no problems, all except my work app doesn't work anymore. The first iOS 14 beta is much better than the first iOS 13 beta. Less heating, more performance, iPhone 6S Plus here. I'll read a couple more. iOS 14 Beta 1, iPhone 11. When somebody calls, sometimes it pops up that there's taking up the whole screen and doesn't give me the option to decline it, and a couple of resprings. Great on my iPhone 8, little to no slowdowns. There is a bug where I want to go into settings, storage, messages, then it crashes. But beside that, this release has been really stable for me. And finally, so great on my iPhone 10S, far better than iOS 13 Beta 1. No resprings for me so far. Pretty smooth. A great update overall. And like I said, for an early beta, this has been phenomenal compared to what we had with iOS 13. So hopefully we'll see it be much more stable over the coming months or weeks. And I would expect iOS 14 Beta 2, not necessarily this coming week, but the week after. Now, Apple could change this up. Usually they take a couple weeks for the first beta, but it's hard to say. However, iOS 13.6, I think, will either get a beta 3 or a public release this coming week. In fact, there's some features with Apple Car Key that are supposed to come out with iOS 13.6 on July 1st. So we may see a public release on Monday or Tuesday before then. So that wouldn't surprise me at all. So I really expect to see those things going forward. Now, as far as this update, if you want to try it out and you're a developer, you probably already know how to do that. If you're not a developer, I really would not advise putting this on your main device. I would wait and put it on an older device, or maybe just wait until the public beta is out. That's usually a little bit more stable and more trustworthy. This does have some issues and it's fine most of the time compared to others, but it's still not 100%. So just keep that in mind if you're going to try it out. Otherwise, it's available for everyone the same day everywhere. Now, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description as I always do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.